Good afternoon, dear children.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Welcome back to geography class. Then, do you remember what all points we discussed in the last class, last week? Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Then, what all points we discussed? Anyone, please summarize all the points. Otherwise, we won't get the continuation. Yes. Yes. Continue. Who will explain all the points? Brief summary of the last class.
We studied out three sections of Himalaya.
We started new lesson, right? Physical features of India. Under the heading physical features of India, we discussed about six physical divisions in India, right? What are they? Six physical divisions. The what Himalayan, are they?
The Himalayan mountains.
The yeah, the Himalayan mountains.
Northern plains.
The Northern plains. The Himalayan mountains.
The Northern plains.
Yeah, second one, the Northern plains.
The Peninsular Plateau.
The Peninsular Plateaus.
The Indian desert.
The Indian desert.
The coastal plains and the islands.
The coastal plains and islands. Then we started with the Himalayan mountains, right? What are the features of Himalayan mountains? We discussed only a few points. Yeah. What are the features of the Himalayan mountains? What are they? Ristwan, what are they? Yeah. Thank you, Ashik.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ristwan. What are the features of Himalayan mountains? We explained four points about Himalayan mountains, right? What are they? Nirupama.
Himalayan mountains are Yangfall mountains.
Yes.
It is its position. It is on northern part of India.
Yes.
It. Varies from west to east or Indus to Brahmaputra.
Yeah, it's run from west to east. Not varies, it run from west to east direction. East. Or we can say, another word we can say, from river Indus to river Brahmaputra. Right. Then.
The distance is 2,400 kilometer.
The distance is 2,400 kilometer. Its width is varying, right?
Sorry, ma'am.
What about the width?
400 kilometer in Kashmir.
Yeah, it's 400 kilometer in Kashmir and
150 kilometer in Arunachal Pradesh.
150 in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, very good. Thank you. Then, next what we learn, Aditya. Yes, dear. Continue. Yes.
Himalayas.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Ma'am, where should I continue?
After Himalayan mountains, the classification, right? Himalayan mountains are classified into three mountain ranges. What are they?
Greater Himalaya.
Yes, the Greater or Himalaya.
Himadri.
Or Himadri. Himadri, very good. Then what do you know about Greater Himalaya or Himadri? What all points we discuss under the heading, the Greater Himalaya or Himadri?
This northernmost group of.
Sorry? Sorry? Aditya, continue. I can hear you.
These are the northernmost group northernmost of ranges. Range.
Very good. Then,
loftiest peak has an average of 6,000 meters.
Yeah, height. Height is 6,000 meter. Very good. Then,
core is made of granite.
Yes, its core part is made up of granite. Then, one more point is
many rivers originate.
Yeah, start from this. Mountain range Himadri or Great Himalaya, many of the rivers. Okay, very good. Then, Who will explain the next one? Himachal Haya. Prajod, can you explain the second division?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell.
I'm Himachal only, ma'am.
Yes, Himachal or Lesser Himalaya or Middle Himalaya.
They are the group of ranges lying to the south of the Greater Himalayas.
Yeah. Next to Great Himalaya, we have Himachal, yes. Right? Very good.
Yes, ma'am. They are composed of highly compressed and altered rocks.
Yes, composed of altered rocks. Then,
longest and important ranges.
Many mountain ranges longest are found in this area, right? What are they? Pir Panchal.
Mahabharat.
Dauladhar. Have you read your textbook?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then some important mountain ranges are, found in this area. They are Pir Panchal, Dauladhar and Mahabharat, right?
Mahabharat.
It is the longest mountain range found in this area. Clear? Okay. Then some well-known hill stations are there. What are they? Well-known hill stations.
Kangra and Kullu.
Then third division, Vishnupriya. Can you explain the third one?
Yes, ma'am.
Shivaliks.
They are the outermost ranges of the Himalayas.
The southernmost range. Very good. Then.
Okay, then extend over a width of 10 to 50 kilometer.
10 to 15 kilometer, right.
And have an altitude between 900 and 1,100 meters.
900 to 1,100 kilometers.
And the longitudinal valley between Himalayas and Shivaliks are known as Duns.
Duns. Okay, then famous Duns are?
Koti Dun and Patli Dun.
One more is there. Dehradun.
Dehradun. I haven't wrote that, ma'am. Okay, then.
What is it? Dehradun, Kotli Dun, and Patli Dun. These are well known Duns. Then, what do you mean by Duns?
They are the longitudinal valleys between Himalayas.
Yeah, the longitudinal valleys lying between Himalayas. Himachal and Shivaliks. Second and third one. Longitudinal valley lying between Himachal and Shivalik are called Duns. Then what is longitudinal valley?
Longitudinal valleys.
What is the meaning of longitudinal valley? Who will answer? Who can answer this question? What do you mean by, what is the meaning of longitudinal valley? Hardi, Amin? You know the answer? I thought you raised your hand for answer the question. And you are just combing your hair.
It means that they are longitudinal.
Sorry?
Lying between Lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks.
Yeah, it's called Duns. Then what is longitudinal valley?
In which valley, longitude.
If you don't know the answer, write it somewhere in your notebook or textbook. Valley between two parallel mountains are called longitudinal valley. Valley found between two parallel mountains. Surya Krishna. Can you tell me what is longitudinal valley?
Valley is parallel between two mountains.
Yeah, two parallel mountains. Two parallel mountains. Clear. Valley found between two parallel mountains are called longitudinal valley. Till this we have discussed in the last class, right? Okay. This range division, this mountain, Himalayan mountains are classified into three ranges. This range division from north to south. Is it clear? This range division from north to south. Then we have another division that move from west to east. We have another division that run from west to east. Actually, this division from west to east depend on or based on the rivers flow into the region, based on the flow of rivers into particular region. Okay, can you see the board? Can you see the board, dear children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Here you can see the name of some rivers: River Indus, Satluj, Kali, Tista, and Dihang. Okay. Then we have learned about the mountain ranges of Himalaya. That range division, it was from north to south. We have another division which move from west to east. Actually, this division is based on the rivers flow into the region. Another division from west to east. It is based on the rivers flow into the region. Okay, then Himalaya, the Mount Himalaya or Himalayan mountain, the Himalayas lying in between River Indus and Satluj, known as Punjab Himalayan mountains. Clear? Himalayas lying between River Indus and Satluj is called Punjab Himalayan mountains. HM is Himalayan mountains. I just given the short form. HM here it is. Himalayan mountains. Then Himalayas lying between River Satluj and Kali, known as Kumaon Himalayan mountains. Better you draw a figure like this in your lecture note. Then between Kali and Tista, Himalayas lying between Kali and Tista is called Nepal Himalayan mountains. Between Himalayas lying between Tista and Dihang, called Assam Himalayan mountains. This is the next division from west to east. Clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
We have another division which move from west to east. This division is based on the river flow. Rivers flow into a region, to the region. Then here, Himalayas lying between River Indus and Satluj, known as Punjab Himalayan mountains. Himalayas lying between Satluj and Kali, known as Kumaon Himalayan mountains. Himalayas lying between Kali and Tista, it's called Nepal Himalayan mountains. Himalayas lying between Tista and Dihang, known as Assam Himalayan mountains. Is it clear? Can I rub it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
I hope it's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
This division is clear. Division of Himalayan mountains is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, anyone, can you explain this division from west to east?
The Himalayan mountain is divided into parts from west to east, region from west to east, in four parts. They are Punjab Himalayas, Kumaon Himalayas, Nepal Himalayas, and Assam Himalayas.
Punjab Himalayas, Kumaon Himalayas, Nepal Himalayas, and Assam Himalayas. Then how this classification comes?
According to the rivers flow from Himalayas
to the... like that, you have to explain. Himalayas lying between River Indus and Satluj, called what?
Punjab Himalayas.
Punjab Himalayas.
Punjab Himalayas. This way you have to explain. Explain it. Continue.
Yes, ma'am.
Badra, can you explain? Badra Pramod.
Ma'am, it is Himalayas.
Yes, Ashik, you are not audible.
Ma'am,
I know you are saying something, but it's not clear. Sometimes your sound is breaking. Your voice is breaking. Okay, I'll come to you later. Badra.
The Himalayas lying between Indus and Satluj is known as Punjab yes. Himalayas.
Himalayan mountains.
Himalayan mountains. The Himalayas lying between Satluj and Kali is known as Kumaon Himalayan mountains. The Himalayas lying between Kali and Teesta is known as Nepal Himalayan mountains.
Yes.
The Himalayas lying between Teesta and Dihang is known as Assam Himalaya mountains.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Then, this classification is over. Mountains classification from north to south. We have explained the last class, first class. Now this classification from west to east. Then beyond Brahmaputra, we have one more range. Beyond the river Brahmaputra, we have Purvachal. What it is? Purvachal, mountain range. Again, we have one more mountain range, Purvachal. What is the name of this mountain range?
Purvachal.
Purvachal.
Beyond Brahmaputra, we have Purvachal. Then is Purvachal. This mountain range is composed of rocks and stones, sedimentary rocks and sandstones. So the features of this mountain range, Purvachal, is composed of sedimentary rocks and sandstones. Then many common ranges which are found in this area are Patkai Hills, Naga Hills, Manipur and Mizo Hills. Then beyond Brahmaputra, we have one more range. It is it's Purvachal. It's Purvachal. Then Purvachal is composed of sedimentary rocks and sandstones. Then the common ranges which are found in this Purvachal, they are Patkai Hills, Mizo Hills, Naga Hills, and one more is there, Manipur Hills. These are the common ranges found in Purvachal. Is it clear? Beyond Brahmaputra, we have Purvachal. Purvachal is composed of sedimentary rocks and sandstones. Some common sandstones, some common ranges are found in this area are Patkai Hills, Mizo Hills, Naga Hills and Manipur Hills. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
What about Purvachal?
Yes, ma'am.
Rissan, what do you know about Purvachal? Rissan. Fia. Fia Harris.
Yes, ma'am.
Beyond Brahmaputra, we have
Purvachal.
Purvachal, then.
It is composed of sedimentary rock and sandstones.
It is composed of sedimentary rocks and sandstones. Okay, very good. Then.
Patkai Hills, Mizo.
What
Mizo. The hills which are common.
Yeah, some common ranges found in this area. Patkai Hills.
Mizo Hills, Naga Hills.
Naga Hills and
Manipur Hills.
Manipur. Okay. Very good. Thank you, dear. I hope this part is clear, right? It's clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Shall I move to the next topic? Plains, northern plains?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We have discussed, first we have discussed the mountain, the Himalayan mountain, the first physical division of India, right? We have discussed about the features of the Great Himalaya. Sorry, we have discussed the features about the Himalayan, we have discussed the features of Himalayan mountains, then Himalaya, classification of Himalayan mountains, the Great Himalaya or Himadri, Himachal or Lesser Himalaya or Middle Himalaya, Shivalik. This range division from north to south. The next we discuss about the division from west to east based on the flow of rivers into the region. And there we have Punjab Himalaya. Then Punjab, yes. Kumaon Himalaya. Nepal Himalaya and Assam Himalaya, right? Then after that, we have learned about Purvachal. Beyond Brahmaputra, we have one more range. It is called Purvachal. Purvachal is composed of sedimentary rock and sandstones. Then some common ranges are found in this area are Patkai Hills, Mizo Hills, Naga Hills and Manipur Hills. Till this, it's clear to all of you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one, Northern Plains. You have learned about North Plains in smaller class, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Plains. Then what about plains? What do you know about plains?
They are flat, fertile land.
Flat, fertile land. How these plains are formed?
Due to how flood. Plains are by rivers.
By rivers. How?
Floods.
Most of the plains are formed by rivers and its tributaries, right? And what is tributary?
Yes, ma'am.
What is tributary?
Water divides and joins.
Sorry?
Where water joins.
Water joins. How can we explain tributary? Vishnu, what is tributary? Branches.
Two or more rivers.
Yeah, small rivers flow into large river.
One,
right?
Main river.
Yeah. Then our branches. We can say branches of rivers. Okay. Then most of the plains are formed by rivers and its tributaries, right? Actually, the river flow from the start from the mountain areas or slopes. It carry some materials from mountains, right? And carry forward all the material and deposit in some places. This way, plains are formed. That you might have learned in smaller classes, how plains are formed, right? Then, so plains are thickly populated areas. Why plains are thickly populated?
Fertile soil.
Yeah, because of its fertile soil. And plains are almost flat land, right? Flat surface suitable for human habitation. Then construction of transport network is very easy in plain land, in flat land. Then flat land is used for human habitation, building construction, construction purposes of building, settlement and for agriculture. That's why plains are thickly populated. You know it, right?
Yes,
all
ma'am.
Of you know why are plains thickly populated. Then let us see about plains. The northern plains. Northern plains are broadly divided into three sections. What are they? The Punjab plain, the Ganga plain, and the Brahmaputra plain. The northern plains are classified into three. What are they? Punjab plain,
Ganga plain, and Brahmaputra plain.
Are you writing all these points?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, then write, copy it down fast. The northern plains are classified into three sections. They are the Punjab plain, the Ganga plain, and the Brahmaputra plain. Then let us see one by one what are the features of each one. What are the features of each mountain? Sorry, each plains. Punjab plain, Ganga plain, and the Brahmaputra. First one is the Punjab plain. Punjab plain is formed by river Indus. Punjab plain is formed by river Indus. One second here. This plain is dominated by Doab. Doab means plains, plain lying between two rivers. In between two rivers. It's about Punjab plain. Punjab plain formed by the river Indus and its tributaries. Then second point, most of the part of most or larger part of Punjab plain lie in Pakistan. This plain, Punjab plain, is dominated by Doab. Doab means between land lying between two rivers. Is it clear? Punjab plain.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear? Then what all points we discuss under the heading Punjab plain?
Yes, ma'am.
It's formed by.
Formed by Indus.
Yes, actually this northern plains are formed by three rivers. Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. Northern plains, all northern plains are formed by three rivers and its tributaries. Right? River Indus, River Ganga and Brahmaputra. Then actually this river plains are, this northern plains are formed of alluvial soil, fertile soil. That's why we discuss as a first point, plains are thickly populated because of fertile soil, right? And it is good for agriculture and farming. So the northern plains again classified into three based on the origin. First one is Punjab plain. Punjab plains are formed by river Indus and its tributaries. Larger part of Punjab plains as in Pakistan. And this plain, Punjab plain, is dominated by Doab. Doab means lying between, this land lying between two rivers. Is it clear? Is it clear, Prajod?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And second one is Ganga plain. Then formed by River Ganga and its tributaries. It's formed between Ghaggar and Teesta rivers. It is between two rivers, in between two rivers. Let us see the features of Ganga plain. This plain is formed by River Ganga and its tributaries, and it extends between Ghaggar and Teesta river. Then this plain, Ganga plain, spread over the states of Haryana, Delhi, UP and Bihar. Second one, Punjab plain. This plain extends between Ghaggar and Teesta river. Then this Ganga plain extends over the states of Haryana, Delhi, UP, Bihar, parts of Jharkhand, West Bengal. In which all states, this plain is extended? Haryana, Delhi, UP, Bihar, and West Bengal.
Ma'am,
is it clear? First one, Punjab plain.
Yes, ma'am.
Punjab plains formed by river Indus and its tributaries. Many tributaries are there for river Indus. Okay, then larger part of this or major part of this plain is in Pakistan. And this plain, Punjab plain, is dominated by Doab because land lying between two rivers. Second one is Ganga plain. Ganga plain formed by River Ganga between Ghaggar and Teesta rivers. And thus plains extended over the states of Haryana, Delhi, UP, Bihar, and Jharkhand and West Bengal. Last one, Brahmaputra plain. This plain was formed the eastern part of the plain. Eastern part. It's in the eastern part. This Brahmaputra plain situated in Assam and it extended over the states of Bihar, West Bengal and Jharkhand. Third one, Brahmaputra plain is situated in Assam and it's extended over the states of Bihar, West Bengal and Jharkhand. The eastern side of, eastern part of India. I will explain the same next class. Okay, this is a time to wind up the class. Okay, I'll explain the same in next class. Okay, thank you, dear children.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.